This is probably one of the greatest stuffed pastas in the entire world. And if you're using store-bought, you're missing out on about 95% of an experience. It is such a versatile thing to make your own tortellini. The reason why is infinite types of fillings, infinite types of sauces, and infinite types of broths. You can put it in a broth, the classic
tortellini and broth.
If you've seen the Chef's Table episode with Massimo Bottura, then you've probably desired to have that tortellini and that broth, that golden shining liquid, just warm, hot, ready for your mouth. And it is as good as it looks. So we're gonna make that, and we're gonna make a second sauce, two different fillings, two different sauce vessels. I'll let the recipe speak for itself. So with all that said, let's make this, shall we? Okay, we got two different tortellini for you here. A classic tortellini in brodo, and a tortellini in a garlicky parmesan cream.
Papa's cream.
Now, you can't make tortellini if you're not making the dough. It's a rule. I don't make the rules around here. Wait, yeah, I do. It's a rule. This is the exact same pasta dough that's in my butt cheaper lasagna, but I'll break it down for you real quick. In a large bowl, start with 2 cups or 300 grams of all-purpose flour. To that, you'll add 2 whole eggs and 3 egg yolks. Begin whisking that together, and once those eggs are homogenous, you'll slowly start to bring in some of the flour from the sides, repeating until you get a shaggy dough. Dump that out onto the counter and begin kneading. Now, once your dough stops picking up flour, you can discard the excess, should there be any, then just keep kneading it for about 5 minutes or until you get a beautifully smooth and supple pasta dough. Wrap that in plastic wrap and let that rest for at least 1 hour. Now let's chat
brodo.
First, we first have to make the brodo di capone. Start with 3 pounds of boneless chuck roast, cut into 3-inch chunks, then start heating a large stock pot over medium high, add enough vegetable oil to the pan to coat the bottom, sear your beef on all sides for 2 minutes each or until you get some nice Remove from the pot and add 1 whole chicken, your seared beef, and an array of rough chopped veg consisting of 3 carrots, 1 onion, and 2 stalks of celery, all rough chopped, 1 teaspoon of black peppercorns, the rind from 1 piece of Parmigiano Reggiano, and 1 bay leaf. Now add enough water to completely cover all of that. Then turn the heat to medium high, and once that just barely starts to simmer, reduce the heat to low and let that simmer for 2 to 3 hours or until the flavor is
immaculate.
I would recommend using a skimmer to skim any scum that rises at the top during the simmering process. Also, big papa rule. Do not let this boil or I will personally write you a letter stating that you shall never receive a kiss ever from papa. Once that broth is done, strain the solids out of the broth, place it in a nice fresh pot, and set to the side. Just a side note, if there's a lot of fat on the surface of the broth, please be sure to grab a ladle and skim off as much of that as possible. Now, for the tortellini and brodo filling, snag yourself 1/2 pound of pork loin chops, dice that into small cubes, then in a large skillet, add 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil and 1 tablespoon of butter. Heat that over medium high until ripping hot. Add your pork and let that sear for 2 minutes or until decently browned. Give it a little stir and continue to sear until it gets some decent color and the meat is fully cooked through. Remove from the pan and onto a small tray to cool slightly. Now in a food processor, add 1/3 pound of prosciutto of choice, 1/2 pound of good mortadella. Give it a nice little love spank, of course. Follow that up with your seared meat and pulse that until you get a fine crumble, but not a paste. Pour that into a bowl and add 1 1/4 cup of grated Parmigiano Reggiano, 2 whole eggs, and about 1/2 teaspoon of fresh grated nutmeg. Give that a nice mix until completely homogenous and combined, and that is your filling. Now, for our assembly, get your pasta dough, divide it into 4 even pieces, cover 3 of those pieces to prevent drying, then shape 1 of them into sort of a flat oval. Run that through the widest setting on your pasta roller, slowly working your way out to about as thin as it'll go. That'll be around a number 5, 6, or 7 on that pasta roller. Take that sheet and cut it into 1.5 inch by 1.5 inch little squares. I know it doesn't seem like much, but trust me, these will make pretty big tortellini. Now you can make them even smaller, like 1 by 1. Brush the border of each of your squares lightly with water, then roll your meat into little pea-sized balls and place them in the center of your little squares.
Oh, little balls and the little squares. So cute.
Now once that's done, we're ready to shape. So pick up a square, pick up your cheeks, then connect 2 opposing points, sort of like you're making a weird triangular taco. Pinch those gently together, then bring the remaining 2 unconnected points together, pinch them, and you're done. See? That's it. Now you can stop crying. Then once all your tortellini are done, being shaped, we're ready for the easiest part. Bring your broth to a boil, season it to taste with salt till it's salty to your liking, then add all of your pasta. Since this pasta is fresh, it's only gonna need to cook for about 1 to 2 minutes, then immediately cut off the heat, fish out your tortellini, place them evenly amongst 4 to 8 bowls, and finally add a generous amount of broth on top. Now look, sometimes there's a little bit of Parmigiano grated on top with a little fresh cracked pepe, but that's up to you. This is beautiful by itself on its own, just like this. Next up, mushroom tortellini in a garlicky parm cream. Oh, and fried sage. For the filling, you need 1/2 pound of cremini mushrooms, first very thinly sliced, and 1/2 pound of oyster mushrooms, also very thinly sliced. Now just rough chop those bad boys until it's what I would call a rough fine texture. Now in a large pan, add 3 tablespoons of unsalted butter and heat over medium heat. Once it's melted and boobling, add 1 shallot and 4 cloves of garlic, both of which have been very finely chopped. Season to taste with salt and saute that bad boy for about 3 minutes or just till softened. Then add 3 sage leaves that have also been, you guessed it, very finely chopped. Give it a little stir just until fragrant, and now you can add your fun guy. Haha, get it? Cause it's a mushroom. All right, I'll see myself out. Season to taste with salt and let that cook down until there's little to no liquid remaining. Then add that bad boy to a food processor and blend until you get it as smooth as you can. Now plop that into a bowl and add 1 cup of finely grated Parmigiano-Reggiano, fold together, and that is your lovely mushroom filling man. I would recommend placing this into a piping bag for easy filling, then get all of your dough prepped out and into 1.5-inch squares, then squirt on a 3/4 teaspoon dot of filling on each and every little pasta, making sure to brush those borders with water so they seal properly. Then just like before, shape all those bad boys, placing them on a lightly floured baking sheet as you finish, and that is your mushroom stuffed tortellini. Now, get a pot of water on the stove, set over medium high, and once the water begins to boil, season it generously with salt. Like, it needs to be about as salty as the ocean. Again, fresh pasta, it'll cook quickly. So before boiling, we're gonna start with our sauce. In a large pan, add 1/2 cup of unsalted butter and 1 cup of heavy cream. Heat that over medium heat until the butter is melted, swirling occasionally to emulsify. Then once that begins to simmer, lower the heat to, low, and let that simmer for 2 minutes. Then whisk in 1 cup of grated pecorino cheese and 1 cup of grated Parmigiano cheese. Continuously whisk until it's fully melted and smooth. Cut off the heat and add in 5 cloves of minced garlic and just a touch of fresh grated nutmeg, salt and pepper to taste. I'm talking like less than 1/4 teaspoon. Now all you gotta do is toss your tortellini in boiling water for 1 to 2 minutes or till al dente. Spider that out into your hot gar parm cream. Add a couple splashes of pasta water and toss vigorously to coat and emulsify. To plate that up, place that beauty into a shallow bowl and top with fresh grated Parmigiano-Reggiano and optionally some fried sage, which is literally just sage leaves that are fried in a thin layer of hot oil till crisp, which takes about 10 seconds. Now, let's give these two a taste test and see if there's a perfect tortellini and whether or not this was even worth it in the first place.
Tortellini makes me wanna put on a big and tight bikini.
We have 2 different ones, tortellini and brodo, and then also Alfredo inspired with a cream sauce. It's okay to have a carnal desire for this, because I do. The broth,
good soup.
See, the beauty of this is the broth alone should take you away, a castaway. It's like a golden bath. It's like you're taking a golden shower. All right, let's eat. A little cheese on this would go a long way, but this came out exactly how I wanted to. If you've never had a traditional tortellini soup, it's a perfect representation of what Italian cuisine represents. It's about extracting every last bit of flavor out of the ingredients. Now, moving on. That counts.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, this is, whoa. This is kind of busting. Man, this is tough. Only because of the weather in Houston, because it is hot, humid, and disgusting. I gravitate more towards this, even though they're both kind of rich. This just feels like you only enjoy this during cold weather, and it'll warm your soul and heart. This, on the other hand, is enjoyable year round. It's rich, it's garlicky, it's deeply cheesy, salty, and that mushroom filling, mushrooms and cheese, it's like some sort of a, this is cream of mushroom, but evolved. If I'm being honest, tortellini is a pretty time-consuming thing to do. So if you're not prepared to do it and you don't have people to mitigate the task to or children to force to do it, then maybe just don't do it. There's nothing more beautiful than making your own tortellini from scratch and using any filling you could possibly want. This is just the beginning of your tortellini adventures. Take it wherever your heart desires. You want to know what else is wrapped in a beautiful pasta parcel, ready to go flying into your mouth hole? B-roll. All right, guys, and that is it. So we made our tortellini 2 different ways, 2 different fillings, a sauce and side broth. Look, the in brodo version can be one of the greatest things you can make in a family setting. You get all your friends and family, get together, make all the tortellini, make the broth, go have fun while the broth is cooking, you got the tortellini all set. It is so satisfying. There's a reason why families have done this for generations. Italians, shout out. The choice is yours, but if you've never done it before, I would highly recommend it. It's a beautiful time, and with all that said, if you enjoyed this video or you learned something, leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you